Good morning, students. Today we'll start with biodiversity and conservation. So this chapter deals with the biodiversity and the types of biodiversity and what are the dangers of biodiversity. Okay, how is it reduced? Then we talk about conservation of biodiversity. So what are the topics do we discuss here? We discuss about levels of biodiversity, the total number of species on Earth, the patterns of biodiversity, and how do we lose biodiversity and biodiversity conservation. Okay. So what is biodiversity? Biodiversity is the heterogeneity. Okay. That is how much difference do we see? Okay. How much variation do we see at all levels of biological organization, ranging from cellular macromolecules to biomes. Cellular macromolecules to biomes. So what is the variation we see? Okay. So the person who popularized the term biodiversity was Edward Wilson. Please remember this. Edward Wilson was the person who popularized biodiversity. So let us look at the levels of biodiversity. So we have genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecological diversity. So we have diversity at the genetic level, at the species level, and at the ecosystem level, that is ecological diversity. So let us start with genetic diversity. In genetic diversity, we should know that diversity is at the genetic level. So they have given an example here. Rowlfia vomitaria, which is in Himalaya, shows genetic variation in potency and concentration of the chemical reserpine. So this Rowlfia, there is also called Rowlfia serpentina. So there, what is happening? You are having only one species. But in that one species, you are having different types. So based on the concentration and potency of the chemical reserpine. So India has 50,000 different strains of rice. So just you go to a shop to buy rice, you would have find so many different types of rice. Okay. So ishtond variety the rice though. Aita. Then you have 1000 varieties of mango. So 1000 varieties of mango. Can you see here? So many types of mango. So it's basically growing in the Asian subcontinent, especially in India. Okay. We have 1000 varieties of mango and 50,000 different strains of rice. So what is happening here? So before that, before I go to the next slide, see here. What is happening here? Even though they all belong to the same species, there is change in the genetic constitution at the genetic level. Next, we go to species diversity. So the diversity at the species level. So if you take a particular area, and how many types of species are found, that is very important. That is species diversity. Example, Western Ghats have a greater amphibian species diversity than Eastern Ghats. So the Western Ghats are here. The Western Ghats are here, this region. The Western Ghats in this region, they have greater amphibian diversity as compared to the Eastern Ghats. So the Eastern Ghats are here. Okay. So this region is the Western Ghats. So know this, very important. Then ecological diversity, the diversity at the ecosystem level. So if you take a particular geographical area, okay, like India, we have different ecosystems here. Which are the different ecosystems here? So we have deserts here, okay, in Rajasthan. We have rainforests in Karnataka. We have mangroves in Sundarbans. We have coral reefs near Lakshadweep and Andaman. We have wetlands. We have estuaries. And we have alpine meadows. Alpine meadows are found in the northernmost tip, that is near Kashmir and all those places. You find alpine meadows. So remember this, very important. So we have ecosystem diversity also. Now, we'll go to the next one. The total number of species, that is the global species diversity on Earth. According to IUCN, more than 1 million species have been described so far. So we have described more than 1 million. 1 million means 10 lakhs. So we have described almost 15 lakh species till now. And Robert May, who says that about 7 million, okay, so considering the species to be discovered in the tropics, that is only 22% of the species have been recorded so far. So he says there are only 7 million which have been recorded so far. Okay. So then animals are more than 70%. Plants, so plantae and fungi together, they constitute 50% of the total species found. Then most species rich taxonomic group among animals is insects. So remember this, it is 70%. Out of the total animals, insects make up 70%. So that is, out of every 10 animals, 7 of them are insects. So remember this, very important. So out of total organisms, more than 70% are animals, and plants and fungi make up to 22%. Okay. Now, out of the total animals, 70% of them are insects. Then the number of fungi species is more than the combined total of species of fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammals. The number of fungi species is more than the combined total of the species of fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammals. So remember this. Then it is not sure about the total number of prokaryotic species because conventional taxonomic methods are not suitable for identifying microbial species. Many species are not culturable under laboratory conditions. Why? Because sometimes they require a host to develop. So all these microorganisms are a problem. We will not be able to put them under taxonomic groups and classify them and name them easily. Okay. Next, we look at biodiversity of India. Very important for NEET. So India is one of the 12 mega biodiversity countries. So out of the 12 mega diversity countries, India is one of them. And India has only 2.4% of the world's land area. So remember this, only 2.4% of the world's land area, but 81.1% of the species diversity. So 8.1% of the total species diversity. So land area bari 2.4% idru kuda, species diversity is 8.1%. And we have 45,000 species of plants, okay, twice as many as animals. So animals adra ardhadashti ashte. Okay. Then applying to May's global estimate, India would have more than 1 lakh plant species and 3 lakh animal species. So bro, estimate maartare that India would have more than 1 lakh plant species and 3 lakh animal species. So remember this. Then patterns of biodiversity. So I think we solved a question in the previous class about patterns of biodiversity, how biodiversity and the vegetation would increase near the poles and is low near the, would be highest near the equator and is low near the poles. Let us look at this. Latitudinal gradients. Species diversity decreases as we move away from the equator to the poles. So what is happening here? Here you have maximum diversity. So remember this. Near the equator. Why? Sun directly falls on the equator. Okay. The sunlight will directly fall on the equator. But it is slanting onto the poles. So as we move away from the equator, as we move away from the equator, what happens? The amount of sunlight decreases. As the amount of sunlight decreases, what happens? As the amount of sunlight decreases, what happens? The plants, species, and their photosynthetic activity will also decrease. As the number of plants decrease, what will happen? The number of animals will also decrease. So species diversity will decrease along the latitudes. So please remember this. So tropics from 23.5. This is 23.5. This is again 23.5. This is south, this is north, okay? And this region here, one second, I'll just erase everything. So this region here, this region here, okay, is called as tropics, or it is called as tropical region, okay. So latitude range 23 degree north to 23 degree south, okay. Here you have more species than the temperate or polar areas. So this would be temperate. This is temperate. Temperate areas. So when compared to the temperate areas, in the tropical areas, species diversity is high. Okay. So than polar areas. These are polar areas. These are polar areas. This is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. Then examples. Colombia, located near the equator, has nearly 1400 species of birds. So remember this, Colombia is located very close to the equator and it has 1400 species of birds. Whereas India, okay, where it is near the tropical latitudes, has more than 1200 species of birds. New York has only 105 species of birds. Greenland has only 56 species of birds. So as we move from the center towards the poles, what is happening? The number of species is decreasing. So you'll notice, equator atra irodralli tumba jaasti birds irutte. Equator inda dura hogta idange enagutte? Birds kammi aagta hogutte. So equator nalli 1400. Okay, very close to the equator it is 1400. Swalpa dura 1200. Innu swalpa dura 105. Innu swalpa dura hodre bari 56 species birth. So remember this, this is very, very important. Okay. So next, tropical forest region like Ecuador has up to 10 times as many species of vascular plant as a forest equal in area in the temperate region like Midwest of USA. So Ecuador atara regions which are close to the equator, you'll have more trees. Okay, you'll have 10 times as many more species of trees in a forest, okay, with the same space. So illi ondu hat ond ekre jagadalli eshtu gidagalu irutto adukkinta tumma kammi gidagalu irutte bere jagadalli adanne illi helta irudru, okay. The greatest biodiversity on earth is in the tropical Amazonian forest in South America. In South America, so what is so important about it? Yak ishton importance kodta idare adike? It has more than 40,000 species of plants, 3,000 fishes, 1,300 birds, 427 mammals, 427 amphibians, okay, 378 reptiles, more than 125,000 invertebrates. So many of them are found in the Amazon. So Amazon forests are also called as the lungs of the earth. They are called as lungs of the earth because they produce so much of oxygen. Okay. Okay. So what is the reason for highest biodiversity of species richness in the tropics? ಯಾಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಸೀಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೆ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ನೋಡಿರಿ, ದೆ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಚ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಹವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ಹಿಯರ್. ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ದೇ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಹೈ, ದಿ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಹೈ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಅ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದೇ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಅ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ದೇ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಟ್ರಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ಟೈಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜ್. ಸೊ ಈಸಿಲಿ ದೇ ಆಲ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ವರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನರಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್. ಅ ಜರ್ಮನ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜಾಗ್ರಫರ್ ಅಲೆಕ್ಸಾಂಡರ್ ವಾನ್ ಹಂಬೋಲ್ಟ್, ಹಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೌತ್ ಅಮೆರಿಕನ್ ಜಂಗಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ರೀಜನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಬಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಅ ಲಿಮಿಟ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಯು. ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಫಾರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಏರಿಯಾ ಅರೌಂಡ್. ಸೊ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಹಾಗೆ ಅದ್ರ ಸುತ್ತ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್, ದ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ? ನೋ, ದಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಅ ಲಿಮಿಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಅ ಲಿಮಿಟ್. ದೆನ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ವೈಡ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಓಕೆ ಟರ್ನ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ರೆಕ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹೈಪರ್ಬೋಲಾ. ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ರಿಚ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ವೈಡ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾ ಟರ್ನ್ಸ್ಔಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ರೆಕ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹೈಪರ್ಬೋಲಾ. ಸೊ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ, ಝೆಡ್, ಸಿ. See, students, then we'll go to the next slide. In species area relationship, very large areas, okay, like the entire continents, that is the slope of line is much steeper, okay. So example, for frugivorous birds and mammals in the tropical forests of different continents, the slope is 1.15. so you need not have to worry much about this, it's easy. Now we'll look at loss of biodiversity. So we have lost a lot of animals because of extinction, so we'll look what are they. So different species have become extinct due to human activity. What do you mean by extinction? So all the animals are dead and gone, so there are no animals left, so that is called as extinction. According to IUCN, International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, they produced a list called as Red List in 2004. So totally 784 species, okay, 784 species have become extinct. In that, 338 are vertebrates, 359 invertebrates, 87 plants have been extinct in the last 500 years. The last 500 years, we have lost 784 species. So remember this, this is very important. 784 species, okay. Full form of IUCN is International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. So example, dodo. Dodo is from Mauritius. This is dodo. Okay, dodo. quagga, which is from Africa, thylacine, Australia, stellar sea cow, okay, from Russia, and three subspecies of tiger. So Bali, Javan, and Caspian tiger. Bali, Javan, and Caspian tiger have become extinct. So very, very important. So red list. So this is here, IUCN red list categories. So look at this. This is dodo, quagga, Bali tiger. It looks very similar to our tiger. Javan tiger, Caspian tiger, thylacine. Okay, so we'll stop here. 1 second, students. So we'll look at what we have lost till now. So 27 species have disappeared in the last 20 years. More than 15,500 species face threat of extinction. So what do you mean by threat of extinction? They're almost becoming extinct. If we kill the other few organisms that are left in the species, they'll become extinct completely. So how many of them are facing? See, 12% of the birds, it's a very big number, 23% of mammals, 32% of amphibians, and 31% of gymnosperm species face the threat of extinction. So they're about to get extinct. Okay, so look at this. The current species extinction rate is 100 to 1000 times faster than in pre-human times. So before humans were there, okay, before humans were there, the rate of extinction what was there has become 100 times more now. Okay, because all of these extinctions are majority anthropogenic, that is human based extinction. So the current species extinction rate is 100 to 1000 times faster. So remember this, 100 to 1000 times faster. It is between this. Okay, 100 to 1000 times faster than the pre-human times. What do you mean by pre-human times? Before the humans came in, pre-human times. If the present trends continues, nearly half of all the species on the earth might be wiped out within the next 100 years. So now ide thara species na saistha hodre enagutte, so more than half of them will be extinct in the next 100 years. So remember this. Then so what is the problem then? So biodiversity hodre tondre eno anta, decline in plant production. So what do you mean by plant production? So nimatra species e kammi agodre production ellinda agutte nimge? So all this pollination and all will not take place. Okay, then lowered resistance to environmental perturbations. So what is the problem here? So enadru sanna putta changes aitu, baragala bantu, tumba male bantu, temperature kammi aitu, swalpa temperature jaasti aitu, the plants will not have any resistance to it. Then increased variability in the ecosystem processes. So understand this, the ecosystem processes will change, such as plant productivity, water use, and pest and disease cycles. All these will increase. So recently we have seen the locust attack. Why? Because of increased temperature, the locusts will also increase in number along with that. So with the increased variability in ecosystem processes, such as plant productivity, water usage, okay, and pest disease cycles. Then what are the causes of biodiversity loss? So let us go one by one. Habitat loss and fragmentation. So habitat and, you know, the region where the organism lives. Over exploitation. So yen upyogisbeko adikinta tumba jaasti upyogisputtivi. Alien species invasion. New species will enter the area. Co-extinction. If one organism is becoming extinct, the related organism will also become extinct. We'll go one by one. Okay. First one, habitat loss and fragmentation. It is one of the most important causes. Habitat loss in tropical forests. Okay. what is happening here? Loss of from 14% to 6%. So 14% land in the bari 6% e bandibide. Thousands of hectares of rainforest is being lost within hours. So gantegalalli thousands of hectares of rainforest have been being cleared. Okay, so Amazon rainforest, which is called as the lung of the planet. Why is it called lung of the planet? Because all are plants and they produce O2 production. Is being cut for cultivating soya beans or for conversion of grasslands for cattle. So there is forest, they are cutting it down to grow soya bean and also for conversion of grasslands for cattle. So forest and they cut money, they are growing grass so that they'll be able to feed cattle. Okay, then when large habitats are broken into fragments, so yenagutta doddu jaga irutta adana piece piece a cut martirtare. Okay, mammals and birds requiring large territories and certain animals with migratory habits are badly affected, leading to population declines. So look at this over exploitation. Next one. So over exploitation andre sikkapatte upayogisputtivi yado on species na. Many species such as Steller's sea cow, this one, passenger pigeon are extinct due to over exploitation. So easy age namge adu sikta ide adin easy age bete aadi tin bidta idar jana. So adrinda yen aagtide tumbha kammi aagogutte numbers adrudu. Then alien species, ili alien andre bere planet inda barbeku anta artha alla, aa jaga bittu bere ellinda navu barutte adakke alien species anta heltivi. Okay, so alien species invasion. Alien species cause decline or extinction of indigenous species. Alien antandre illi exotic antane helbodu. Exotic andre yado bere jagadinda bandide anta. Indigenous andre artha eno? Local anta artha, alle iruvantadu. So iga nimmanna yararu kelidre tengin mara eno? Indigenous species. Parthenium eno? Exotic species athwa alien species, adello bere kadeyinda bantu. Okay, so alien species cause decline or extinction of indigenous species. They have given an example here. Nile perch introduced into Lake Victoria. So Nile perch is a fish introduced into Lake Victoria, that is East Africa. Okay, caused extinction of more than 200 species of cichlid fish. Okay, cichlid fish. Okay, so what does this Nile perch do? It will eat up all the food that was for others' fish and it will eat up the fish also. So it caused extinction. Then invasive weed species like carrot grass. So nivella kelirthira idana Parthenium. Okay, carrot grass. Lantana camara anta heltare. It's a hedge plant. Beligalalli beliyutide. And water hyacinth. Icornia. So you, all of you know the other name for water hyacinth, that is Terror of Bengal. One second. Caused damage to our native species. It caused damage to our native species. Then, illegal introduction of African catfish. Carias garipinus for aquaculture is posing a threat to the indigenous catfish in our rivers. So namma river galalle catfish ide, but African catfish is eating up the indigenous catfish. Smaller ones it will eat up and it will also eat up other small fish that are there. So it will cause a great loss in biodiversity. So it is banned in India, though. So you can't grow African catfish in India. Okay, so can you see, this is the Nile perch. It's a huge fish which will eat up other smaller fishes. Cichlid fish. Then we go to the next one, that is co-extinction. So what is co-extinction? When a species become extinct, the plant and animal species associated with it will also become extinct. Okay, so yadadru one species extinct aagta idre adra mele dependent aagirutte athwa adra jothe close association alli irutte. ಆ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, extinction of the parasites when the host is extinct. So extinction of parasite. So remember this. Parasites are dependent on the host for food and shelter. Host is satoyito antandre parasite ill irutte. Correct? Atra. Then co-evolved plant pollinator mutualism. So yavadadru on plant irutte adukon specific pollinator irutte. Like honeybee or some bird. So extinction yavadaru ondradadre innondu kuda extinct aagibidutte. So remember this. This will lead to co-extinction. So yavadadru one species extinct adre adru jothe associate aagiro innond species kuda extinct aagibidutte. So idina channa gnapaka ittkobeku. Very important. Okay. So ನಾವು ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯೋಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿನ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಯಾಕೆ ಬೇಕು, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು, ಆದರೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್, ನ್ಯಾರೋಲಿ ಯುಟಿಲಿಟೇರಿಯನ್, ಬ್ರಾಡ್ಲಿ ಯುಟಿಲಿಟೇರಿಯನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಥಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಫಸ್ಟು ನ್ಯಾರೋಲಿ ಯುಟಿಲಿಟೇರಿಯನ್. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನು ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ, ಏನೇನು ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ. ವಿ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಸೊ ಜ್ಞಾಪಕ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನ್ಯಾರೋ? ತುಂಬಾ ನ್ಯಾರೋ ಆಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಫುಡ್. ಸೊ ಊಟ ನಮಗೆ ನೇಚರ್ ಇಂದಾನೆ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ಫೈರ್ವುಡ್, ಸೌದೆ, ಫೈಬರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋತ್ಸ್, ಕಾಟನ್ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಸಿಲ್ಕ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ. ದೆನ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್, ವುಡ್, ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್. ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟ್ಯಾನಿನ್ಸ್, ಲೂಬ್ರಿಕೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಡೈಸ್, ರೆಸಿನ್ಸ್, ಪರ್ಫ್ಯೂಮ್ಸ್, ಈ ಗಂಧದ ಎಣ್ಣೆ ಅದೇ ಪರ್ಫ್ಯೂಮ್ಸ್, ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಗೇನೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ದೆನ್ ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ 25% ಆಫ್ ದ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ 25% ಆಫ್ ದ ಡ್ರಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 25,000 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. 25,000 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಸೊ ಕೀಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಲಿಟರೇನ ತುಂಬಾ ನ್ಯಾರೋ ಆಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನೇನು ಸಿಗ್ಬೋದು? ಬಯೋಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅ ಮೇಜರ್ ರೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಈಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್. ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್, ಅಮೆಝಾನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ 20% ಆಫ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ O2 ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ಥ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್? ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ಥ್. ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ಥ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಬೀಸ್, ಬಂಬಲ್ ಬೀಸ್, ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇರ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ ಬೀನ್ ನೋ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್. ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ನೋ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್? ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಏಸ್ಥೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಏಸ್ಥೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್? ಸೊ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಅ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ ಹಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್, ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ನೈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಆಗುಂಬೆ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಚಿಕ್ಕಮಂಗ್ಳೂರ್, ಆರ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಬೀಚ್, ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏಸ್ಥೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್. ದೆನ್ ಎಥಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಇಂಟ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಎನಿ ಆನಿಮಲ್, ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಾಣಿ ಆಗಿರಲಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ, ಅದರದೇ ಆದೊಂದು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಾರಲ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ ಏನು? ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವೆಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ವೆಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ದೆಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಕೀಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇಟ್? ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್, ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್? ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಜಾಗ್ರಫಿಕಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಸೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಆ ಪ್ರಾಣಿ ತನ್ನ ಜಾಗ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇನ್ನೆಲ್ಲೋ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಏನೋ ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್. ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ ಸೈಟ್. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಇಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ಅಕರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ಅಕರ್. ಸೊ ಹುಲಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹುಲಿನ ತನ್ನ ಕಾಡಿನಲ್ಲೇ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, So let us see what are they. It includes protected areas such as national parks, sanctuaries, biosphere reserves, cultural landscape, natural monuments. All these are in situ conservation. They conserve it in their own area. Then India has 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national parks, and 448 wildlife sanctuaries. So it has 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national parks, and 448 wildlife sanctuaries. So remember this, 14 biosphere reserves, 90 national parks, wildlife sanctuaries. So remember, it is very important. Then, national park. Look at this. The area which is strictly reserved for the welfare of wildlife, where private ownership activities like cultivation, grazing, etc. is prohibited. Example, Eravikulam National Park in Kerala. So what is important about this? There you can't own land. So alloge jameen tagoladakke agodilla. Alli eno cultivation madakagala, agriculture madakagala, vyavasaya madangilla, alli pranigalnu meeso agilla. Okay? Absolutely for animals. That is national park. Then sanctuary andrenu. The area in which protection is given only to animals. Operation like collection of timber, minor forest products, and private ownership rights are allowed. So long as they do not interfere with the well-being of the animals. So what is happening here? Here you can own land. ಹಾಗನ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇಡೀ ಕಾಡ್ನ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಜಾಗ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು? ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಳಂದೂರು ಅಥವಾ ಆ ಕಡೆ ಮಲೆ ಮಹದೇಶ್ವರ ಕಡೆ ಕೆಲವು ಕಾಡುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಥರ ಸ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಚುರಿ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಡು ದೇ ಡೂ? ಸೊ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಮೈನರ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಚುರೀಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್, ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕಾಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್. ಈಗ ನಾಗರಹೊಳೆ, ಬಂಡೀಪುರ ಹತ್ರ ಬಾರ್ಡರ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ರೆಸಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇದೆ, ಆದರೆ ಅದು ನೇಚರ್ ಜೊತೆ ಇಂಟರ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರದು. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬಯೋಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್. ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಈಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಕಂಟೈಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್. ಇವನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಯೋಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅಲೌಡ್. ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್. ಇಡೀ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ಬಯೋಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಅದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಸೇ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ಬಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲೀವ್. ದಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿ ಬಾರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ ದಿ ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇರೋರ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಆಚೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅದು ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಈಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದೆಮ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಆರ್ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಗ್ರೋವ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇವರ ಕಾಡು ಅಂತೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಆ ಥರದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೆವ್ರಲ್ ಟ್ರೈಬಲ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ದೇ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಗಾಡ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ದೇವರು ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಆ ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಜಾಗನ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಕಾಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಡು ದೇ ಡೂ ದೇರ್? ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹಂಟ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಪೋಚ್ ದೇರ್, ನೋ ಬಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಲೌಡ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎನಿ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಚ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಂಗಲ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಗ್ರೂವ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಸೇಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಗ್ರೂವ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಖಾಸಿ ಇನ್ ಜೈನಿತಾ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮೇಘಾಲಯ, ಅರಾವಲಿ ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಫ್ ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನ್, ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ, ಸಾರ್ಗುಜಾ, ಚಂದಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಸ್ತಾರ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್, ಚಂದಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಸ್ತಾರ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್. ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್, ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಟಿಲ್ ನೌ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್, ನೌ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್? ಆಫ್ ಸೈಟ್, ದ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ಜುವಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಬೊಟಾನಿಕಲ್ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್? ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ಯು ವುಡ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಜೀನ್ ಪೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಜುವಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಝೂ ನೋಡಿರ್ತೀರ ನೀವು, ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ರೇರ್ ದೆಮ್. ಬೊಟಾನಿಕಲ್ ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಾಲ್ ಬಾಗ್ ಕಬನ್ ಪಾರ್ಕ್, ವೇರ್ ದೇಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಜಿನಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಟಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದನೂ ತಂದಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋದು ಬೆಳೆಸಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೀನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಹಾಟ್ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್. ಹಾಟ್ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ರಿಚೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಥ್ರೆಟನ್ ರಿಸರ್ವಾಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆನ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 34 ಹಾಟ್ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 3 ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, 3 ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. Which are the three hotspots that are there in India? Western Ghats. So where is the Western Ghats? So this whole region. Western Ghats. Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka. And Indo-Burma border. Indo-Burma and Himalaya. So that would be in the north and northeastern part. They cover the biodiversity regions. They cover the biodiversity regions in India. Western Ghats. Right. So, what are the international efforts for conservation of biodiversity? So, just paata madidre saka yenadru law madirbeku athwa rule madirbeku where different countries will say yes to it. So, what do they do? What are the objectives, okay, of these international efforts? So, one of the international efforts is Earth Summit, which was held in Rio de Janeiro. So remember this. This is also important for NEET. Earth Summit, which was held in Rio de Janeiro in 1992. So what does it talk about? It talks about conservation of biodiversity. Talks about conservation of biodiversity. Sustainable use of biodiversity. What do you mean by sustainable use? You use the biodiversity things, but you don't destroy them. So, new survive agbeku, biodiversity conserve agbeku, athara. Then, sharing of benefits of utilization of genetic resources. Sharing of benefits of the utilization of genetic resources. Remember this, sharing of benefits of utilization of genetic resources. So, genetic resources can be shared between countries and utilized. So, Rio de Janeiro, please remember it. Okay. Earth Summit. Then, there was something called as World Summit on Sustainable Development. So remember, I told you what is sustainable development. Sustainable development is where nature will also be conserved and there is development also. So yeraduku advantage agbeku athara, which was held in 2002 in Johannesburg, South Africa. In Johannesburg, South Africa, and 190 countries pledged to reduce the current rate of biodiversity loss. So they pledged to reduce the biodiversity loss. So this will bring you to the end of the synopsis. So we'll start with MCQs. Last, next slide, go. Determined by biodiversity is determined by, yes, it is number of individuals in an area is correct. Species richness is also correct. But looking at A option, A is a better option. A is a better option. Evenness. Okay. Evenness. What do you mean by evenness? All the organisms are the same. For example, if you have a gadde, what do you mean by evenness? You have a gadde. Ali species richness irutta. Evenness irutte. So illi biodiversity is determined by number of individuals in an area, correct. Species richness one level correct. Evenness alla. It is not determined by evenness. It is determined by the variations, number of species in a area. Okay. Then we go to the next slide. Next question. Which one has greater diversity? So nidahanak nodi idana. All of you read all the options and then answer. Slowly answer. Take your time. Don't be in a hurry. Answer slowly. So, all of you are answering good, we'll see. So, what do we have here? I'll just give you a hint and again you try to answer. We have three bird species plus, not really, four bird species of one and one bird each of other two species, not really. Four bird species of one, so we have three birds. So, this is a very nice question. So, no, first, ತ್ರೀ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಮತ್ತು ಫೋರ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಫೋರ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಟು. ಇನ್ನೂ ಎರಡಿದೆ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅದರ್ ಟು, ಒನ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ ಟೋಟಲು ನೋಡಿ, 7, 8 and 9. We have 9 birds here. Okay. Then let us look at this bee. So we have 6 birds of 3 species each with an individual. So nodili 6 birds of 3 species each with individual. So 6 birds there. Total is there 6 birds there. Okay. Of 3 species. Each with individual. Three species and they know. Three species is alva. One under lestir bekaga. Two birds plus two birds plus two birds. Correct? Six irbeku. Three species. Three species is then the first two, the second, the third species. Each with individual. Okay. Then two animals, each of three species belong to different taxonomic groups. No deal. There are two animals. Each of yav animal anta kottila ile. Three species. Each of three species. So there are three species belonging to different taxonomic groups. Okay. So yavda one barkona. Adan X anta itkona now. Aita. Two animals alva. Three species. One X plus 2Y plus 2Z. So they have just told two animals each of three species. One, two and three species. ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ನಮಗೇನು ಅನಿಸ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ನೇ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ವೈ? ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ 9 ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇರೋದೆ 6, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದೆ 6. ಸೊ ಇದೇನು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿಸ್, ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 3 ಬರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ನೋಡೋಣ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಎರಡು ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಮೂರಾಯ್ತು, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ 4 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್? 6 ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 3 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. 1, 2, 3. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 3 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಬಿಡೋಣ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ 3 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್? A is from the same taxonomic group. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಾನಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇಂದ ಇಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಹೈಯರ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ? ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ? ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ದೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಪುಟ್ ಬಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಬರೀ 3 ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು ನಿಮಗೆ ಈ ಥರದ್ದು. ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ದ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅರ್ತ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ, ದ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅರ್ತ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ. The species diversity on plants on earth will be, what will be B? B is the correct answer, 22%. So we've done this in the synopsis. We've done this in the synopsis part. Go to the next question. Most biodiversity rich zone in India is? Think and answer. Most biodiversity rich zone in India is? Yes.
ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ವಾ?
ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಮೇಜರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಮೇಜರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ಯಾ, ಸೊ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಟ್ರಾವರ್ಸಸ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಲಾಂಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ. ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ. ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ಟು ಗೋವಾ, ದೆನ್ ಟು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಟು ಕೇರಳ. ಸಿ, ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕೇರಳ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಕೇರಳ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇರಳ. ವೇರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಉತ್ತರ ಕನ್ನಡ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾರವಾರ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ಟು ಉಡುಪಿ, ದೆನ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್. ಆಲ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕೋಸ್ಟ್. ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಚಿಕ್ಕಮಗಳೂರು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕೂರ್ಗ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೊಡಗು. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ಫುಲ್ ಮೇಲಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸಿನಾಪ್ಸಿಸ್, ಐ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದ ಲೆಂತ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು, ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು So types of species within a community would be species diversity. So A is not correct. Types of community in an area is wrong. Yes, gene based diversity would be right. Let us look at this. Genetic diversity and evolution of species within a genus anta kottidare. Within a genus you will have many species. So C is the correct answer. So C is the correct answer. The number of known species of organisms on this earth is about, the number of known species on this organism is about, on this earth is about, yes, yes, many of you have given the right answer. Yes, very good. It is 1.7 million. It is 1.7 million. Go to the next one. Which one of the following shows maximum genetic diversity in India? Which one of the following shows maximum genetic diversity in India? So even I have done this, the synopsis I have told you. Okay, yes, rice is the correct answer. So 5,000 different varieties of rice. So it is not mango. Mango is only 1,000. Mango is only 1,000. Okay, rice is more than that. So in India, we find mangoes with different flavors, colors, fiber content, sugar content, and even shelf life. The large variation is an account of, please answer. In India, we find mangoes with different flavors, colors, fiber content, sugar content, and even shelf life. The large variation is an account of. So think and answer. They all belong to the same species, but they have different genetic constitution. So please answer. So very good students, very good. So it is not species diversity. Why? Mango belongs to one species, that is Mangifera indica. You don't have different species of mango. Okay, So it is not due to induced mutation. We don't bring about mutation. Yes, it is correct due to genetic diversity. We don't hybridize it. So what we have got is all due to genetic diversity. There are more than 1,000 varieties of mango in India. So genetic diversity in agricultural crop is threatened by. So munche tumba varieties of rice belita idru ivaga iglu belitare, but why it has become less? All those old varieties are gone. So haled yenen itkon belita idru desi taligalu ant yen heltidru adella hotogide iga yake anta kelta idare. Please answer. Answer, students. So let us go one by one. So yes, we have introduced high yielding varieties, that is true. So intensive use of fertilizer is not true. Extensive intercropping, if you had done extensive intercropping, we would have got more species, that is true. Intensive use of biofertilizers is also wrong. Introduction of high yielding varieties, ivaga enagide hybrid varieties tumba bandirodrinda we are all using hybrid varieties, and all those old varieties what we are using, so you know ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಸಿ ತಳಿಗಳು ಏನಿರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು, ಹಳೆ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಏನಿರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು, ಅದನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಗೋಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಡೋಡೋ ಆಫ್ ಮರಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಡೋಡೋ ಆಫ್ ಮರಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು Dodo of Mauritius became extinct due to. Answer, students, it's a very easy question, direct question from NCERT. So it became extinct due to over exploitation. So sikkapatte adana vaddu saayisi tinbitru, over exploitation. So habitat destruction andre they did destroy the habitat. Dodo was found in the islands of Mauritius, where all these sailors who went there killed dodo and they ate it because of its flesh. So it was very easy to catch them and eat them, so they over exploited it. Okay, bete aadi aadi tindakbitru, so adrinda extinct aagoyitu. Then, so please answer it, answer this. We'll go with the assertion now. Assertion: tropical rainforests are disappearing fast from developing countries such as India. That is true. That is true. This is correct. This is true. Okay. Then, no values attached to these forests because these are poor in biodiversity. False. So no value on the kotidare. There is a lot of value to these forests. Okay, because they are poor in biodiversity. This is also wrong. They are rich in biodiversity. They are rich in biodiversity. So the assertion is true. Reason is false. So where is it? Assertion is true statement, but reason is false. So remember that. Very easy. Okay. Good. many of you have answered it. Which of the following is most dangerous to wildlife? Please answer, which of the following is most dangerous to wildlife? C correct answer. See, which of the following is most dangerous to wildlife? See, overexploitation is also dangerous to wildlife. Man-made forest doesn't come under this. So the actual correct answer is habitat destruction. See, overexploitation would only destroy one species. Okay, that is also correct. Overexploitation will destroy some wildlife, but when we look at the comparative level, man-made forest, no, it will add up some biodiversity. Habitat destruction. So, for example, if I destroy a part of Western Ghats, so Sumne Ankona, I go to the Uttarakhand district and there is some taluk like Yellapur. And Yellapur dalli iro ella maragalnu katsak putre enagutte? Nanage anusute nan bari maragalnu ashte cut martidini anta. But along with that, what is happening? I am destroying life of other organisms also, like birds, insects. So aa kaadnalli iruva ella pranigalgu nan tondre kodta idini. Okay, so if you destroy the habitat, you are actually destroying the animal also. So adhe tane aagtiradu. So kaadna cut maadkonde bartta irthivi ond kadeyinda, we are destroying the habitat, we are destructing the habitat. So what will happen? So the plants will also grow, go along with that the animals which are dependent also will be in danger. So habitat destruction is most dangerous. Okay, so kaade illadang maadibitre pranigalu ellu hogutte aitha, adre over exploitation enatte kaadu irutte yado one pranin matra hunt maartirthivi. So nan sumne yado one kaadu hogtini bari jinken matra hunt maartini, I will only hunt deer. So first what is happening, I am killing more amount of deer, but at least plants are being safe. Nan ella maragalna cut maartila, but nanu maragalne cut maadkon bandibitre enagibudutte. So jaagane illidira pranigalu ellu hogutte, correct ah? So habitat destruction is very important here, most dangerous. So over exploitation correct, introduction of foreign species correct, but habitat destruction is more dangerous. Then answer the 13th question. We'll go one by one. Which of the following factor does not play a role in increased biodiversity? So in biodiversity jaasti aagbeku antandre yenen idralli act madalla anta kelidare. Complex population interactions, these are found, this is true. So introduced species, no, these will not play a role. Then higher degree of habitat heterogeneity, this is true. Narrower niches, this is true. So they have asked which of the following does not play anta kelidare alva. So which of them does not play? It is introduced species does not play a role in increased biodiversity. Why? You bring a new species to that, it will not add to the biodiversity, it will destroy the other organisms there. So complex population interactions are found in increased biodiversity, higher degree of habitat heterogeneity is seen, narrower niches are seen. So introduced species is the correct one. So the alien species introduced into Lake Victoria was responsible for extinction of chitrid fish was. So African catfish is not the correct answer. So that will African catfish will actually destroy the normal catfish, indigenous catfish and other fishes in a water body. Water hyacinth is stellar of Bengal, it's actually a plant. Carrot grass is also a plant, that is Parthenium. Nile perch is the correct answer. Easy question, direct question from NCERT. So in this chapter there is not much of twisted questions, they are easy to answer. So please answer the next question. So, yes, correct. Human activities are, so let us look at the question, sorry. Extinction is a naturally occurring phenomenon. That is true. For example, like Archaeopteryx, they have become extinct naturally. Okay, that has occurred on Earth since life began. That is true. Scientists are also so concerned about extinction now. So, ivag nadithiro extinction bage scientists tumba tale ketchukottidare yake. Human activities are directly responsible for today's mass extinction. That is true. Nammindane aagta irodu. Extinction is occurring at the faster rate than even before faster rate. Correct. 100 to 1000 times faster. 1000 times faster. So, correct. Large number of plant species which form the base of the terrestrial food web are becoming extinct. Yes, they are base of the terrestrial food web. Why? Because they are plants and they are producers. So, the correct answer is all the above. No dealing. Opted for D. So, yalla correct agirudrinda yenagutte? So, it is D. Go to the next one. The animal extincted from India is ilve illa India nalli anti irodu yavudu? So, nanu gottu tumba confusing anisuthe question. The animal extinct from India is, oh, good. Quite a few have answered. Illappa, lion ella extinct agide India inda. India na lion ide. So, A is not the correct answer. So, I'll tell you something. This is a nice question. So, the animal extincted from India, it is not lion. It is not lion. Lion ide India na. Gir forest alli innu ide. Deer, jinkegalu, adu ide India nalli. Peacock, navilo, adu ide India nalli. So now you will say, sir, chirte illa alva sir, extinct agila alva, na chirte kelta irthivala. What you see in India is a leopard. It is not a cheetah. Are you understanding? Leopards and cheetah are different. So one that is extinct from India is cheetah. Okay? Are you understanding? So, namma oorgalu allella baruttala. Adella yenadu? It's a leopard. It is not cheetah. So please understand this. So nan gottu tumbha jana ee tarad question madi takshana yavudu idra correct answer alla anta ankotare. Lion inna India nalli ide. Okay? Done. We'll go to the next one. Rhinoceros are found till nowadays. Where is it found? Done. So, rhinoceros is found both in Asia and in Africa. The one that is found in Asia, that is in India, it is one-horned rhino. So, onti kombina genda mruga. Okay. It is one-horned rhino. So, what is found in Africa is a two-horned rhino. Two-horned rhino. So understand this. So D is the correct answer. Go to the next one. Introduction of Nile perch in Lake Victoria of South Africa resulted in. So this is an easy question. Why we asked the same question, same type of question before? Tumba easy ide. Which is that? It is elimination of many species of chitrillid fish. Then, the largest endangered bird in India is? Ide syllabus alli. Flamingos, namdalla, bitbidi. It has not been. Flamingos are migratory birds. So please tell me, students. It is. Yes, it is the great Indian bustard. The great Indian bustard. We'll go to the next one. The organization which has published Red Data Book is. The organization which has published Red Data Book is. So it is IUCN, that is International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resource. A is the correct answer. A is the correct answer. Then, those species whose population have been seriously depleted and whose ultimate security is not assured are known as. Those are endangered species. Easy one. Go to the next one. The species listed in Red Data Book are. Please answer. The species listed in Red Data Book are. So yes, threatened are there, endangered are there, rare are there. All of them are listed in the Red Data Book. All of them. So yenen solpa threaten agutho on solpa kammi agutho adella Red Data Book ag bandbidutte. Okay. Then assertion. So I have got some question. So please answer this assertion. India is one of the 12 mega diversity countries of the world. Yes, that is true. Then India has only 2.4% of the world's land area, but its share of global species diversity is 8.1%. That is also true. So now based on this, can you please answer whether it is 1, 2, 3 or 4? Yes, one is correct. Both assertion and reason are true, and it is the correct explanation of the assertion. Go to the next one. Manas Sanctuary is located at. Manas Sanctuary is located at. So this sanctuary is very close to Kaziranga National Park. Where is the Manas Sanctuary located? So Manas Sanctuary is located in close association with Kaziranga National Park, which is in Assam. So the next, which part of the world has a highest diversity of organisms? Which among them will have the highest diversity? So here we have deciduous forests. Deciduous forests usually don't have it. Why? Because they are forests which shed leaves in summer. So deciduous forests, you find them in India. So they don't have the highest diversity. Grasslands, it is not true. Why? The major producers in grassland is only grass. You don't see much of trees there. Savannas is not true. Tropical rainforests are correct. Why? Because highest amount of rainfall, water availability and sunlight is with tropical rainforests. Because tropical rainforests are found in between the tropics. That is Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. So you have the highest productivity and they have the highest density of organisms. Then, from equator to poles. Okay. If this is the earth and this is the equator, this would be the Tropic of Cancer, this would be Tropic of Capricorn, this is North Pole and this is the South Pole. So the region here is the tropics. This region is the tropics. The tropics would receive maximum rainfall. They have very good amount of temperature that is required for development and evolutionary process. So they've asked what happens from equator to poles. As we move from the equator towards the pole, the biodiversity would decrease actually, decrease. So we'll go one by one here, okay? Biodiversity decreases, size of the body decreases, ecosystem productivity increases, stability of ecosystem decreases. We'll go one by one here. Which of them are correct? That is what they mean here. The biodiversity will decrease, that is true. Size of the body increases, that is also true. Why? The organisms in colder areas are much more in size when compared to the organisms close to the equator. Then ecosystem productivity increases. This is wrong. The productivity actually decreases there. Then stability of the ecosystem decreases. Yes, that is true. The stability of the ecosystem will also decrease as we move from equator to the poles. So third one is the correct answer. 1, 2 and 4. So the pattern of biodiversity is affected by. So that's a direct question from NCERT. They've given latitudinal gradients. That is true. That is true. Species area relationship. That is true. So both 1 and 2 would be right here. Both 1 and 2 would be right here. Then there's a very simple question. One of question asked previously in CET. Just as a person moving from Delhi to Shimla to escape heat due to duration of hot summer, thousands of migratory birds from Siberia and other extremely cold regions move to. So this is a direct question from NCERT. This is Keolado National Park in Bharatpur Sanctuary in Rajasthan. Okay. So it's not the Western Ghats. It's not the Meghalaya. It's not the Corbett National Park. Then Bali, Javan and Caspian are three. Please answer this. This you would have studied in extinction. Yes, they are species of tiger. So these are extinct now. Extinct. In India, ecologically unique and biodiversity rich regions are legally protected as. Please answer. So yes, biosphere reserves is true. Hotspot is true. National parks is also true. Okay. But sacred groves, they are not legally protected. They are protected by the usual civilians that are found in that area, concerned with a local god there. Okay. Wildlife sanctuaries is true. One second. Hotspots are not in the group. So A, C and E. Then match the following. So please answer this. The Earth Summit was held at Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, and in 2002, whereas the World Summit was held in Johannesburg in 1992. So 4 would be the correct answer here. So we'll go to the last question now. Assertion: hotspots are the regions of accelerated habitat loss. Yes, in hotspots there is habitat loss. Hotspots are the regions of high levels of species richness. That is also true. That's also true. Both of them are true. But this is not the correct explanation for the assertion. So here, both of them are true, but it's not the correct explanation of the assertion. So we'll stop here, students. So the next